Welcome back to my channel. So I have a little project share for you. It's for my week 14 of 24 weeks of Christmas. And I lost the original footage of the tutorial and stuff. And if you want to see me do it again, I can. Just let me know. But I'm pretty self-explanatory. And I'll show you what I'm going to do. Now this project was inspired by Kelly Barlow from Kelly Barlow's Creations. Go check her out. I'll leave the link below to the original video in the description box. Now, I hauled this a few weeks ago from Dollar Tree. It was a Dollar Tree clay. And I wanted to try it out. And, you know, I didn't know what color it was because it just showed this. Well, it is definitely this color. And this clay is like the same clay you can go out if you live by the river and dig it up out of the riverbank. I mean, they probably cleaned some of the stuff out of it, but it's the same kind of clay. Now, it was a little difficult to work with, I'm not going to lie. I only made one using this clay here. Might give it another shot, but I don't know. Then, the second one I made, I used my Crayola air dry clay. Now, it's not the same as the foam clay. This is the same kind of, it's clay, it's just like regular clay. But it was a little bit more pliable, a little bit easier to work with, and I think the results came out better. So I also used in this project some Dilutions paint. This was called Cherry Pie, and some of the Black Recollections Metallic Black. I think this is either like a kind of a puffy paint or whatever. But these were gifted to me by Angie Burkholder, Angie and Andrew. I used some Artist Loft acrylic paint. This is a metallic blue. I used some Folk Art orange. I think it was just plain orange. I don't know what the name of it is. It just really doesn't say. It just gives a vivid orange. Okay. And then I use some heavy body white acrylic. Now, it's important on this clay when you're painting it to use a heavier body base paint. And that's what I did with this. Then I use black and orange magic marker. So this is what I made. So the first one I made was this right here. I made some little snowman ornaments. Are they not adorable? So this is with the red clay. Now, you can tell it's not as, I don't know if you can, it's not as smooth as I wanted it, but I still think it came out adorable. I used this cookie cutter from the Dollar Tree to cut my circles out. And then what I did was I cut two circles out, one for the base of the snowman, and then I cut another circle and cut it in half, and then cut one little tiny strip off. The half is for the hat, and then I had a little strip right here for the band of the hat. And I put little marks in it, like, you know, you folded a little hat or whatever. Put that in there. And then I took another tiny little piece of the red clay and rolled it into a ball for the ball of the hat. Now, it's not, like I said, I think it's adorable, but it definitely has some imperfections in it from the clay cracking and stuff. Now, this is the one that I made from the Crayola. And the texture is really different. This is a whole lot smoother. It dries very smooth. It did not crack. And so I did this the same way on both of them. And see, I don't know if you can tell on the ridges right here in the hat, it's a lot smoother. It's smooth underneath. So I really like the way this turned out better. But all I did for these was, after they dried, now you need to let air dry clay dry for at least 24 hours. It says it can dry, it can take up to, well, 2 to 3 days. So I made the circles and stuff all in one day to adhere these parts right here. You just use water. And now on the red clay, I did take my finger and wet it and try to smooth the clay out as best as I could. I did not have to do that on this one because it just smoothed out after you rolled it out. And I just used a rolling pin to roll them out. So I adhered the little hat on with water, and then I adhered the little band on with water. And then before I did anything else to them, because you can't paint them when they're wet, I let them dry for 2 days. And then I came back and I painted 2 coats of white all over the whole thing, the hat, everything. And that's when I used this right here. I painted 2 coats over it and let that dry completely. And then this has some texture. It's like, it's almost like Crystal Nouveau drops or something like that. This is my recollection, so. And I just dotted, well, first I did, I used my marker and dotted the place where I wanted the eyes and the little smile, whatever. And then I went back over it with this paint right here and I just dotted it on there. So it gave it some texture, made it stand out. Then I took my orange marker and drew out the carrot nose first. And then I took a fine liner paintbrush and went back over it with the paint. So it kind of gave it a two-tone and made it, you know, have a little bit more texture. It wasn't just that bright. It had some lines and stuff in it. And then I went back over and painted the hats with the respective paints, the cherry pie and the acrylic blue. This is called metallic cobalt blue. And then this, of course, is the cherry pie from the Delusions paint. And I just think it came out adorable. And all I did was take a Chanel stem, cut it in half, and then folded it into like a little loop. And I put a big gob of glue on the back, stuck the Chanel stem into it, let it dry. And then I went back over top of it with some more hot glue. And I did that for both of them. And they're holding really nice. Now, I wouldn't mind making some more of these. Because, like I said, I'm going to have sort of a traditional Christmas tree this year. It's not going to be nautical theme like I usually do. So, I have a lot of ornaments and stuff from my childhood that I want to be using. And I thought I would fill these in. Now, these would be really, really cute if your kids wanted to get involved with it. I would recommend using the air dry clay like something like this. This came from Hobby Lobby. I bought it a long time ago. It was $5.99. Of course, you know I didn't pay $5.99 for it. You could get that soft bendable clay, you know, but I don't think that stuff would work very well. But I am really pleased with the white clay. And you just put it on a mat, a nonstick mat, and and roll it into a ball, flatten it out, and then cut it out. And my circle is about maybe not quite a quarter of an inch thick. I don't even know how to tell on this, but it's about an eighth of an inch thick. So this is a good thickness to roll it out to about an eighth of an inch thick and then cut it. And it takes 1.5 circles to make one ornament because you have to do the little hat and the band and stuff. So, it was really simple. Like I said, I'll put Kelly Barlow's original video, link it down below in the description box. And she made hers with fondant. And I just didn't want to go out and buy any fondant because, you know. So, and this I don't have to worry about critters coming after. Of course, she sprays hers with lacquer so they won't come mess with it. But it's, I just, you know. So, anyway, this was a really cute project. I enjoyed doing it. And I may make some more of these, but like I said, these would be great for the kids, except for, you know, you might need to help them roll it out or something like that, but it's just fun and very simple to do. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow for my week 15 of #24 Weeks of Christmas. All right, see you guys later. Bye.